I'm not sure if you would be available, so you could tell me if you like him or not, if you're a fan.
Come back and waste my time with that garbage. Caesar in Staten Island, what's up, Caesar?
How you doing, Mike?
What's happening?
I just called to ask you one thing, Mike, about with all these football players getting arrested. Did you get a chance to read or see the J.J. Watt?
I mean, I'm very familiar with J.J. Watt. I don't know what you're referring to.
Okay, I'll tell you. There was a car accident in Texas with a family of five. The mother and father wind up dying. The two boys, all the kids was under, I think, 12. And the two boys were paralyzed, and the girl broke a lot of bones, but she's not as critical as the two boys. And J.J. Watt stepped right in and spending time with the boys, took them to games, did a wheelchair move in a game for one of the boys, for the boys. It was just a great story.
Well, listen, I mean, J.J. Watt, I mean, I guess your point is that J.J. Watt was a former quarterback who was a successful college football player. I watched J.J. Watt play in college, saw him play in person. Has gone on, obviously, with a political career and a successful career in the oil business. I guess that, yeah, that's your point. Yeah, there's, listen, there are plenty of athletes who are good people. Plenty. The majority. But the problem is we have to do something to control the small number who aren't. And yes, the number gets, you know, I've seen people apologize to the NFL and say, well, it's 1% of the players. Well, you know what? It's 1% too many. That's all. It's 1% too many. Oh, is he talking about, J.C. Watt? I thought he meant J.C. Watts. Okay, J.J. Watt, the current player. I thought he meant Julius Caesar Watt. Okay, I thought he was J.C. I thought it was J.C. Watt. Okay, the old Oklahoma quarterback. It's J.J. Watt he's talking about. Okay. Well, either one. They're both athletes. What's the difference? Okay, one played a generation ago and is an athlete, a politician. The other one is a current all-pro player. Either one. The idea being good players versus bad players. Okay? And maybe there have been, I think the number was there were 30 arrests since the calendar year in the NFL. 30 players have been arrested. Now, is that a large number when we're dealing with the entire rank and file of the NFL? I don't know how we deem what a good number is. I'll tell you what a good number is, zero. That's a good number. Is that a realistic number? I don't know. But when you do have, the one thing I would say that's different, did players get in trouble generations ago? Yes. Was there always guys who were bad guys? Yes. There were players who mistreated women. There were players then that mistreated women. There's players who were too physical and assaulted people. There are guys now who do that. What I say has changed is we seem to have a far less of a value for human life than we used to. It seems like human life for the younger generation is more disposable than it used to be. That, I think. And guns seem to be, and maybe I'm wrong about this, guns seem to be more prevalent now. I don't have any numbers to back that up. I'm just going on what it feels like. I don't know if it's true or not. I don't know the numbers. If you gave me the number of NFL players who had gun arrests or had gun-related charges 30 years ago and those now, I don't know if the number, it would seem much larger now, but I don't know that it really is. I don't have any facts to back it. But, and this isn't just an NFL, right now it's an NFL issue. And maybe the NFL issue is larger than the baseball and the NBA and the NFL. I don't know. I haven't looked at the study. I haven't looked at seeing what percentage of baseball players were arrested versus what percentage of hockey players versus what percentage of basketball players versus what percentage of NFL players were arrested in the last, 5 years. I haven't looked. Someone could do a study and give us the numbers. But, it's bad. There's no question. It seems to be far more prevalent than it used to be. Whether it is or not, I don't know. I really can't answer. I don't know what about Vince McMahon. You know, somebody did a book about 10 years ago, and the point was how many, you know, serious arrests and how many, and we're talking about, you know, not just, you know, everyday charges. We're talking about really serious crimes. That there was a very high number in the NFL. I don't know if that number is overwhelming compared to the other sports. I really couldn't tell you. You know, but I'm sure somebody's done some kind of study on that. But when you see things like this, I mean, it's going to overwhelm people. There's no question about it. Does Aaron Hernandez give the NFL a bad name? Yeah, he does. Because he was an NFL star. He does. People look at that and say, there's the NFL name. He does. There's no way around it. This is a prominent team. This is a prominent player on a prominent team. This is a kid who's a star player making, you know, very big contract. So yes, he does put the NFL in a very poor light. There's no way around it. Mike Burgess, what's up?
Welcome back. Before I get to my point, echoing what you said about Joe and Evan, you know, I think as far as I'm whining about having to do 5 and 6 hours,
the
bigger issue is having to listen to them.
Well, I was only kidding.
Anyway, I hope you're having a vacation. Two things that fall under the, you can't believe until you hear it, title. First of all, with Aaron Hernandez in the jersey, I totally agree with you as far as the great move by the Patriots exchanging the jersey. But I don't know if you read the article in the Post a couple of days ago, but on eBay, his jersey is going for upwards of $300 each. I don't need to tell you what that's probably.
Well, that doesn't surprise me though, because hey, listen, that's why people are interested in serial killers, because there's an unsettling fascination with stuff like that for whatever reason. I mean, there is. Okay, so I mean, that's just the way. That doesn't surprise me in the least. And the few of the ones that weren't changed, that were not returned, I guarantee that there's a place somewhere where people